Well, good morning. It's Thursday the 16th of February 2016. Welcome along to today's United Kingdom Talk. Now, you notice the mirror ball is turning, as it always is on this programme, unless I forget. Oh, even worse than forgetting to turn it on, yesterday morning, which is the last time you saw this large bulbous item turning before you, yesterday, but I forgot to turn it off. The thing has been turning all day and all night. Oh my God, just think of electricity bill, dear. G Energy I'm with, G Energy. My electric bill is going to be through the roof just for this turning for one day. How many watts or units of electricity is that using? That's the wonder. Dear me, do remember to turn off your electrical items and unplug them from the wall socket before you go to bed. Thank you from Thames Television. Yes. Good morning to all our early people this morning. Good morning to Waynie, karaoke extraordinaire and DJ. Waynie's not got fed up with the DJing, not like I have. Waynie is still DJing to hundreds of people every week, aren't you, Waynie? Happy good morning, Waynie. Oh, incidentally, we're on another microphone today. I've got one of these, which I've had for some time. Listen, you can hear it. Okay, you can hear that. Does this sound just as good, the same? Because this has become a bit of a pain. Because Ray Reynolds, who's already with us this morning, kept moaning that he could see the arm. You know, here's the arm. There's the arm. He kept moaning, so I can put that right out of the way now and just have my little clip-on microphone on instead. I hope this sounds as good. Perhaps I'm sure you'll tell me if it doesn't, all right? Good morning to Paul Arthur William. Good morning, sir. As I say, Ray Reynolds is with us this morning. Zach. Good morning, Zach Thompson. How are you, dear? Long time no see. Zach's there. Gustav says, have I twiddled my knobs? No, I haven't. I have now. Thank you, Gustav. Waynie says, could we have some announcements while this hold music is playing? Please hold. Chris knows you are waiting. Don't you? It's not a telephone. It's not a telephone. This is a television programme, dear. It's not a telephone, dear. You know... Hello, the number you were calling knows you were waiting. Please hold the line while you try and connect us. Yes. Thank you for calling Orange Customer Services. We're sorry, all our operators are busy at the moment. However, your call is important to us and you are held in a queue and will be answered shortly. Please hold the line. No, this is not a telephone, dear. It is a worldwide television show with millions, let me see, 9 million viewers watching at the moment. That little number in the corner is millions, okay? Remember, that is actually millions, not single numbers. Good morning to JC. Good morning, John. Says, morning, what is the name of the first piece of music at the beginning of the 5 minute countdown? Don't know, John. Really sorry, I don't know. Do you wish for that piece of music? Do you wish to purchase that piece of music? Let me know if you do. Good morning to Adam. Morning, Adam. I've been playing around with a computer last night again. Oh, yes. Yes, I've now set up cameras with certain regular callers' phone-ins. I think, Adam, you are the most regular caller on this programme now. I do. There ought to be some sort of competition, I think, where a prize will be given for the person who calls in the most. Do you like that idea, lover? Yes. Good morning, Adam. Morning to Chris Andrews. Good morning, sir. Nice to see you as well. Zach Thompson, did I say 2016? Are you sure? Did I say it's 2017? Thank you, Zach, for your corrections. Thank you very much for your corrections, Zach. As I say, Chris Andrews is watching this morning. Morning, Chris and Adam. Yes, there we are. So last night, we had a wonderful, wonderful quiz last night, I tell you. Oh, it was fantastic. Such a lovely atmosphere in the King's Head Theatre Bar. That's where I do the quiz every Wednesday night between 8:30 and 10:30. 8 teams, which is nice. A little bit low. We like to have 10 teams, but 8 is quite acceptable. And Ray Reynolds and that bloke from Hospital Radio Romford came. What's his name? Pete Ward was there. Hospital Radio Romford. Ba 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 ba. It's the afternoon weekend show with Pete Ward. Ba 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 ba. Hospital Radio Romford. Yes, he does a little station. He says he goes on air. I don't think he actually goes on. I think it's all through wires. I think there's wires coming out of Pete Ward's. He keeps telling everyone he's got this radio station. Well, I haven't heard it. I haven't heard this radio station. Good morning, Michael. I haven't heard this radio station. I reckon he does what I used to do when I was a little boy. Although he's not a little boy. You know, He's not a little boy. No, he's not. I used to have wires in my bedroom, right, when I lived in Roehampton, and it would come out of my house, out of my bedroom, first of all, into the kitchen, that was the first one, and then into the living room, that was the second one, and then into my neighbour's house. I took a wire out of my bedroom, all the way outside our front door, along the balcony, and I had a speaker in my neighbour's house. That's how I started doing radio. But it wasn't really radio, it was through wires. I reckon Pete Ward is doing it through wires. I don't think there's a transmitter. Oh, transmitted here. Oh, terrible. Good morning to Cordy. He's there as well. Nice to see you all this morning. Is it sounding all right? Actually, Adam will tell me. Let me know if this is sounding all right tonight, because I can always go back to the other microphone if it's not all right. So great quiz last night. As I say, 8 teams in there. I think I had verbal diarrhea last night. I think I might have spoken more than I read out questions. I mean, that is a possibility that happened last night, I think. I couldn't shut up last night. I don't know why that was. I think it was the fact that I was a little bit lonely during the daytime. Didn't really see anyone except the blokes at the swimming pool. I can't remember what we were chatting about yesterday. And one of them's just bought a caravan. He's actually going to live in a caravan. He's selling his house, which is actually not far from here. And he's going to, well, first of all, he's already bought the caravan. He's bought a caravan down in Selsey. Now, it's quite a popular place to have a caravan, isn't it? Selsey, which is really nice, down on the south coast, near sort of, I think it's Worthing and Wittering, Chichester. You've got Brucklesham Bay, Bognor Regis, all sort of down that way. And he sold his house so that he can help his children with their purchase of their house. Isn't that a nice thing to do? He's going to live in a caravan, not one of the cheaper ones. You know, he's gone sort of, you know, quite a large, one of the larger ones. And as I was saying on the show, as I say many times on the show, I don't think there's anything at all wrong with living in a caravan. I think it's lovely. They're lovely. It's a brand new little house you've got there. It's a mobile home. It's a mobile home, really. Cordy says, have I got a cold? No, why? Should I have a cold? Do you want me to have a cold? There's a news story about that, getting colds. Look here, that links in nicely, doesn't it? Daily vitamin D lights. Check this out. In this morning's Super Sore Away Sun, taking vitamin D tablets daily or weekly. Why would you want to? Well, which is it, daily or weekly? I mean, if I took my tablets weekly, I'd be dead. I have tablets each morning. I'm a bit susceptible to infections. So I have tablets every morning and every evening, actually, to stop that, or to, at least to try and stop that happening. It says, those who take the 2 pence, but it says here weekly or daily. Well, they haven't researched that very well, have they? Those who take the 2p appeal sunshine vitamin, because you get vitamin D from the sun. Hello, where? Where? Not in this country. That regularly cuts the chances of respiratory infection, which I'm particularly susceptible for, by 12%. The protection level the flu vaccine offers. Hey, this might be worth doing for me. And those with the biggest... Oh, something's fallen off. Right? Those with the biggest deficiencies who took it daily cut their risk by half. Queen Mary University, London found. So it's not Tuppence Hospital or University have said this. Queen Mary University, London. Da, 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 da. Yes. Vitamin D is thought to fend off respiratory infections by boosting antibiotic-like substances in the lungs. Oh, have I got those in my lungs? There are things living in my lungs. Yes, it's produced by the body when the skin is exposed to sunlight and found in fatty fish. Oh, no, no. Is that those things like tuna? And what's those nasty things that come in oil? Pilchards. Oh, they stink. My mum used to love those pilchards. Do you like pilchards? Oh, they come in a little can. You can get them in tomato sauce or brine, which is, I think it's that salty. And they're horrible and oily and they stink and they're horrible. My mum used to love them. She'd have them on a Saturday afternoon, on a Saturday night. Yeah, she'd have like some sort of salad and then a couple of those pilchards on the plate. Oh, and the little bones. Oh, no, don't like them. It says, safe sun messages about skin cancer have led to more people covering up when outside. Well, I wish the fat ones would. I mean, you don't see... I'm fat. You wouldn't see... You wouldn't see me walking along with a crop top on. Have you seen some of them, dear? Walking... I was going to come to that. There was two blokes in the swimming pool again yesterday. Right, about my age. Bit overweight, just like me. One much more overweight than the other. What did they have on? Cycling shorts. I mean, for Christ's sake, man. Well, someone's going to have to tell them. Maybe if I write a little note. I write a little note and push it into their locker so that... So that when they open the door, they get the little light. What shall I put on it? Please don't wear cycling shorts, you fat bastard. Something like that. Would that be offensive at all? You know, would you be... I don't have a problem with overweight people, such as myself, using the swimming pool. But for Christ's sake, wear a pair of loose shorts or something. Not cycling. It makes you even look even bigger. Why do people think they look good in that? Dear me. The results of the vitamin D thing fit in with the observation that colds and flu are the most common in winter and spring when levels of vitamin D are at their lowest. And that's true enough, isn't it? Oh, remember that flu I had back in, when was that? October, I think it was. September, October, I had flu badly, which I picked up 3 days after getting a flu injection. I might go on these, actually. Let me make a note of this. Vitamin D help for people with people. I've written that down now. I should look that up later. Respiratory infections led to 35,000 deaths. Look at that. And 300,000 hospital admissions in a year. So, of course, anything to help the hospitals. You know, I think we should all start taking vitamin D, according to the Sun. I mean, if it's in the sun, it must be true. You know that. Researchers say the findings strengthen the argument for fortifying foods with vitamin D, such as cereals, orange juices and dairy products. So that's interesting, that is, isn't it? I don't know. Do you take a vitamin D pill or capsule or anything like that? What do you take, boys and girls? Do you take any pills other than... those prescribed by the doctor. We don't want to know your illnesses. Unless you want to tell me, that's fine. I'm not asking you your illnesses. But do you take a vitamin pill of any sort in the morning? If so, call in and tell me about it. I have a phone number open this morning. It's and I have my button pushed. So callers will be heard live on air. The phone number is 020-8144-3477. And once again, I've been playing about with a computer last night when I got in. So things will be even smoother than they were yesterday. Unbelievable, isn't it? 020-8144-3477 is my phone number. Or if you have Skype, you can Skype in. My Skype in is all one word, United Kingdom Talk. So United Kingdom Talk is the Skype in. And the phone number is 020-8144-3477. Do you take pills in the morning? Multivitamins, vitamin C, vitamin D, something like that. Do you honestly think it's benefited you? If so, tell me about that this morning. 020-8144-3477. Okay. I've had breakfast this morning and for the first time in ages, I had porridge. I got these from Waitrose. We went to Waitrose the other day. Was it yesterday? I can't remember what day it was now. Anyway, this is really nice porridge. Flaveners Irish porridge oats. All the Irish know how to make their porridge. You know, and these ones, this is one of the instant ones in a packet. Look at this. And it says, delicious creamy porridge in 2 minutes. I actually have two of these, you know. It's a little bit girly, that, isn't it? A little one. Real men have two. Real men... sorry if you've only got one, but... No, real men have two, okay? There you go. Two of those you want. And it's very, very nice. Some of these instant porridges are a little bit flimsy. You know what I mean? I find the ready brick type of thing... There's no... Oh, I don't know how you would put it. It doesn't seem to be as thick. The bits of porridge are not thick. We like thick bits of porridge. So I can highly recommend this one. This is the instant one, Irish porridge oats. Or you can get the normal one that you either make in a saucepan or in a slow cooker. Now, I did have the thick one. The best one is the thick one, okay? It's even better than that. Same make, but the thick one. You want jumbo rolled oats, something like that. And you put that in your slow cooker and you leave it for overnight or whatever, a few hours, and then in the morning it's done. The only thing is, I found it stuck to the bottom of the slow cooker thing, which isn't too much of a problem. You know, you just soak it or you put it in the dishwasher or something like that. But and you have to keep putting the dishwasher on. So I gave up with that one, and I do that now in a little glass bowl. Here's another one that's really nice. Dorset cereals. Heat me up and eat me up. Now, that's not bad as well. That's the one with honey. Dorset cereals with honey. Very tasty indeed, all right? So I had porridge this morning for the first time in ages, and that was nice. But perhaps I should be having a vitamin tablet as well. Do you have vitamin tablets? Let's have a look at some of your messages coming in on the show today. Good morning to Kevin Webster, who's with us this morning. Kevin likes thick porridge as well, don't you, Kevin? Thank you, Kevin. Good morning to you, sir. Adam says, I'm off to Bognor today for work and staying there for 2 days. Oh, really? 2 days in Bognor? Oh, you'll have to go to Butlins. Did I go to Butlins Bognor? I think we did once. I think we went to Butlins Bognor once. No, I was older. No, my mum and dad took Gary and Tracy. That's my niece's nephew. One of my nephews and my niece, when they were little children. I mean, they're both married now with children, but they did take them to Butlins Bognor, I think. And I popped down there for the day. I wasn't there very long. I remember restaurants and having a little look around there. Yeah, it's all right, Butler. Nothing wrong with holidays in this country. I keep telling you that, don't I? Good morning to Colin. Colin's with us this morning. Morning, Colin. Gustav says the thick one is very satisfying. I find that as well, Gustav. Those little thin things, I mean, they're a bit of a joke, aren't they, dear? You can't actually... I like to chew it a bit, don't you? I like to chew my porridge in the morning, yes. Good morning to Elaine, who says... I'm making her hungry. Elaine, presumably porridge is... Would porridge be a thing that people have in Israel? What is a typical Israeli breakfast, Elaine? Do let us know. I mean, I've been to other countries, like in France, where the breakfast is nothing like us. You have your selection of cereals, but then they have cheeses and bread and pastries and all that. Now, see, I've just had breakfast and it's just the porridge. I had porridge and a banana as well. No, we like a banana. Nana. Na 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 na. Do you remember the banana splits? That programme on the telly, children's programmes. La 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 la. Do you remember that? Excellent programme. Excellent programme. Typical in Israel is salad, cheeses, egg, coffee and toast. Oh, that sounds a little bit French to me. The Israeli breakfast, very similar to the one I've had in France when I've been at Euro Disney. Won't be going back there for a while. Next time I'll go to the States, I think. Dear me, very disappointed with the price of things there. Good morning to Nick Evans. Nick is in California. Now, I haven't been to California yet. I know you've got a Disney there, but I've got a feeling if I went to Disney in California... I'd be disappointed because I've been to the one in Florida. Once you've been to the one in Florida, I don't think... Although the one in Tokyo's quite good. I heard that the Disney in Tokyo's pretty good. But I wouldn't be able to read the writing, dear. It's all squiggle. It's a bit like Hebrew. Obviously not Hebrew. But, you know, it's squiggles. It's not proper letters, is it? How would I know what to eat? Oh, I fancy a veggie burger. Ooh, what one's that? You won't know, will you? Do they speak English in Tokyo? Tokyo, yes. Speak English. Adam says, for frequent callers, you could do a trip to New York for the winner and you could do some show from the back of a New York cab. I like that, Adam. Who's going to pay for the trip to New York, dear? I'm not rolling in money here. I'd have to sell a property. We can't be selling things yet. Not yet, dear. Not in this young part of my life. 020-8144-3477 is the calling number. 020-8144-3477. Shania, once again, is at work. You work so hard, Shania. Oh, she's a hard little worker, Shania. Elaine says, when you were here, you stayed at hotels. How did you like the Israeli breakfast? Yes, actually, you're right. Yes, it was. It was exactly as you said. No, we had bits of cheese. I quite like cheese in the morning is nice. We tend not to have that here, but having some cheese and a bit of bread and a few other bits on your plate. And I think there was a daily freshly made salad, fruit cocktail type thing. You know, it was all in a bowl and you helped yourself to that and put it in your plate. I sprinkled a few bran flakes or corn flakes on top and had that. You know, as well as, because of course, when you're on holiday and all the breakfast is included, you do tend to have more, don't you? Huh? When I was in the States a few years ago at the Disney there, breakfast was included for me, and you'd eat all this food thinking, and I used to eat all this food and first thing in the morning, Denny's. I also went to Denny's. Oh, I love Denny's. Breakfast at Denny's, you can't go wrong. Have you seen the amount of food that comes out? God's sake. When I took my nephew there a couple of years ago, we went to Denny's. Well, I think we only went once for breakfast. And this he looked at me and said, I can't eat all that. Because my nephew, he wears those super skinny, slim jeans, doesn't he? Well, by the end of our holiday, he couldn't do those up. Which really upset him. I mean, that really upset him. But all this food comes in. And the idea would be that you eat a very, very large breakfast and then you won't have to have lunch. Well, it doesn't work like that, does it? It doesn't quite work like that. So, yeah, you come out of Denny's or wherever you've had breakfast. Poor God, damn. Anyway, you need to go back to bed and have a rest. It's worn you out eating the breakfast and shoving all this food down your throat, isn't it? Oh, dear, dear me. And you come out of there and you go to Disney and after you've been walking around, I feel a bit peckish now, even though you've eaten all that. So it doesn't quite work like that, unfortunately. Not at all. Let's have a look. Just scrolling down. Don't want to miss your messages. There we go, right at the top there. Waynie Martin says he's packing. What are you packing for, Waynie? You haven't won anything yet, dear. You've never called in. You've never called in once, Waynie Martin. How can you possibly expect to win a prize, dear? It's for the person who calls in the most. Not once have you called in. Yeah, in fact, you don't even call my normal phone. When is the last time you rang me on the phone? And you wonder why I don't ring you anymore, dear? I've stopped ringing people who never ring me. Oh, but I send it to... Oh, I'm really busy. Well, I'm too busy to ring you then. Too busy to give you the prize. I suggest you open that case and take those clothes back out again, lovey. Yes. No holiday for Waynie. No. You take yourself off to Butlins or somewhere like that. Nothing wrong with Butlins. Look above what? What am I looking at? I'm looking above. Look above what? At what? I'm looking. Look above at what? Kevin says, that's a nice shirt you've got on, Chris. Thank you. Kevin, this was about £30, this one from Amazon Direct. Amazon have got some very, very good quality clothes on there. Cheap. Now, of course, if this was a Ralph Lauren, you'd be looking at £100. 30 quid this was, Amazon. If you type in floral printed shirts, okay? Floral printed shirts. Waynie says, Chris, you could afford to take all your viewers to New York. How do you work that? Are you suggesting I don't have many viewers, Waynie? Is that what you're saying? How rude. There are 9 million people watching this programme at this moment, if you don't mind me saying so. Thank you. Adam says, how about setting me a GoFunds Chris for New York? Yeah, I could set up one of those GoFundMe things, couldn't I? There's a few people do that. There's one bloke I know on there who's, I think he's into drugs and that sort of thing. He's actually set up one for homeless people and no one's ever put any money on it because everyone knows what the money would be spent on. You need to watch those GoFundMe things. I could set one up there, say, I don't know, you know, I need a new ear. I need a new ear. I haven't got the money. Please, could you donate? And people donate. You've got to be very, very careful of those GoFundMe things. Check them out before you donate any money, okay? Good. Let me see. So I don't know, you know,
I need a new...
1 minute. 1 minute, I've done something wrong. There we are. That's better. Bring that back up there. Good. There we are. That's done there. Right, so last night, as I say, we had a fantastic quiz in there last night. We streamed the quiz last night on Facebook One Colour. It's the second time we've done that. But I had the camera in a much better position and people were playing along at home. We had quite a few people watch that last night as well. And I put the camera in between Ray Reynolds' group, who won last night. Ray Reynolds and the group won last night. Congratulations. Now, that's the second time they've won. So very pleased. They won a £30 bar tab. And Pete was there, Paul, and who's, I can never remember the other bloke's name. They were all sitting there, and they've been a few times now. They've actually won twice, so congratulations to them. I don't know what's going on with the short planks. Now, the short planks are a regular little group of people that come in. And in the last few weeks, I have to say, their team has got smaller. It is shrinking. And this is something that does happen, boys. As you get older, it is, and they are shrinking very fast. Last night, it went down to one team member, the lovely Johnny, who he's got an antique business. The people in there, oh, they've got good jobs in that place. Oh, they've all got money in there, dear. Champagne socialists in there, that's what they are. They've all got loads of money. It's true. Who's calling in now, please? Good morning.
Good morning, it's Waynie.
Good morning, Waynie. Oh, my God. Wow, I can't believe it. You've actually called into this programme live.
Well, I thought going to New York with you, I thought, well, I better call in.
Well, I say live. That's a bit debatable, really, isn't it, Waynie?
Yeah, so I'm half dead.
Do you take any of those tablets then in the morning?
I take vitamin C.
All right,
and collagen.
Yeah. And do you honestly think that helps you or not?
No, I still get colds.
It doesn't help your back. You suffer from a bad back, don't you, Wayne?
Yes, yeah, well, that's, that won't, vitamins won't sort that out, that's for certain.
Poor old soul, dear.
Yeah, getting old like you.
Do you have to have many, have you had operations on that? Because my mate, Ronnie's had quite a few operations on his back there.
No, my mum has, though, and hopefully I will have to go down that road. But, unfortunately, every so often, the back goes into spasm and causes me no end of grief. But, hopefully, and I'm going to touch a bit of wood, I won't go down the route of operations. It's right. Quite painful.
Now, I had that back spasm thing a little while back. Do you remember?
Yes.
Didn't I cancel? I had to cancel on you, didn't I?
You did. At the same time, I had a bad back as well, so we were both out of action.
I remember because I went in. I went in a little while back, if I remember rightly, and whoever it was looking after the pub that particular day knew. They said, "Oh no, not you as well. Wayne has got one as well." I remember that.
Yeah, and I had two people to go and help me, and they come along the whole night. All I had to do was be the voice to put people on the stage. But like yourself, those few weeks were hell. You know, it was painful.
Not nice at all. Oh well.
No.
So you're not been to New York at all, then, dear?
No, I'd like to go. So I'm going to leave this suitcase packed, and I'm in the contention for. For sharing the cab with Adam and yourself.
So I'll have to put a little note on your thing now, I guess, will I?
Yeah, no, I'm going to be phoning every day now, you know.
Waynie has now called in once.
Are you allowed to phone twice in one show? Would that count?
I think that's pushing it a bit, to be honest. I'm just trying to get your photo up here.
Put you on speed dial.
I'm putting people's photos on here now as they call in. I've selected a nice one of you there. There you are. That's come up there. I've got to resize that. Once I've put it on once, it keeps coming up. There you go. There's a little picture of you.
When I phone in now, are you going to get a big picture of me on your screen, are you?
Yes, you are. Yes. You're kind of next to me. I'm still there, and you're kind of next to me, next to the clock, with your peanut head. Are you actually got less hair than me, or do you shave it off?
I shave it off, yeah.
Oh, you do, dear.
Yeah.
Is that a weekly
thing? Well, no, about every week and a half.
Okay.
I've got a nice young lad at a barber shop that I go and visit.
Oh, where's that one?
We talk.
Which one is that?
Just cheat. You're a pricker. In Caversham, in Reading.
Oh, in Caversham. I go to one in Wokingham.
I know that one, and they've got a few nice young people in there as well,
yes,
haven't they?
Max. You know Max? He's got a new shop. He's got a new shop now.
Has he?
Well, you know he used to be on the right-hand side.
Yes.
Well, all those shops along there have closed now because it's all being knocked down or done out, isn't it?
That's right.
Yeah, they're having a regeneration. Regeneration.
They're getting Lidl's as well, aren't they?
Pardon?
They're getting a Lidl's.
Oh, no, an Aldi. They're getting an Aldi.
Aldi, sorry, yes.
Yes, yes. Awful. That'll bring the crap into that area, won't it, dear?
Oh, dear. Terrible.
Awful. So he's got a new shop on the left now. Now, Waynie, you often hear me talking about caravans, which are basically mobile homes. You live in one, don't you?
I do, yes.
And
yes.
You love it.
I moved into one about three and a half years ago. And I'll tell you what, Chris, after 36 years of living in bricks and mortar, I love it. I wouldn't have it any other way. It's brilliant living. It's 26 foot by 24 foot. And, yeah, lovely. It's my little world. I love it. Got a garden. Yeah, to me, it's great. I love it.
Do you have... Is it one bedroom or several bedrooms? Or?
Well, that's the only thing with mobile homes. They're like new-build homes. They say it's two-bedroom, but the second bedroom, well, it's probably big enough to put a spare one sort of single bed in, and that's about it.
Well, not just mobile homes, my friend. My niece has got a new build house, and I mean, they're, of course, they're completely used to it. But compared to my spare rooms, you know, they're just tiny, these bedrooms. Do you know, up from the road on me on the right, near Sainsbury's, is a relatively, I say new, they're probably about 20 years old now. But when they built those houses, me and my mum went up there just to have a nose, really, you know. We went in this great big house. And you open the door and the most wonderful staircase going up and a great big hall, right? And we thought, oh, this is nice. And then you went and looked into the rooms and they were tiny, the rooms.
Yeah.
And you were thinking, what builder would give the space to the hall and the stairs if not to the rooms? It didn't make sense to us.
Yeah. Well, apparently a house sells itself in the first minute and a half. So, you know, when you're walking through the front door, that's, you know, what you see. So obviously they have to make that look good. But, yeah, unfortunately, with new houses, or well, as far back as the 90s, really, the sort of bedrooms are the last thing to be thought about. And quite often, unless it's the master bedroom, it's small and very compact.
Yeah, I suppose they are, really. But you love your place. Do you have to pay? Do you have to pay ground rent there?
It's all in one. It's it's ground rent and. All the amenities as well, are all in one charge. So yeah, it's all covered under one monthly payment.
When you say everything, what does that include then?
You know, the sewerage and the water. All in the grounds thing, because it's all without being too grim, it's all dealt with on site before it goes off into the main sort of sewage system. The water comes in through one big main and it's split off. So actually putting us all on water meters would be difficult. So they just basically put it all together in the ground rent, and that's all charged in one go.
May I ask how much your ground rent is?
I think it's £109 or something like that a month. But that also, includes the water and includes, sewage, etc.
£109 a month? That don't sound too bad at all to me.
Yeah.
I rent
the place as well, so I've got rent as well on top of that.
It's not yours.
No.
Okay.
No.
What rent would one expect to pay somewhere like that then?
Well, it all depends on what sort of size you're going for. But I've got one of the sort of the more bigger ones on the site. And so all in all, it's £700 a month, including the ground rent and the rent I pay for the mobile. You get to come over and see it, so you need to at some point.
Yes, I'd love to. Yeah.
Pay a little visit, you know. So. I'll let you use my Wi-Fi and maybe do a show from here.
Oh, that would be nice. Have you got a rapid internet connection there, lovey?
Not as fast as yours, but...
Oh, dear. You're not on 3 mile an hour BT or Sky or Talk one, are you, lovey?
I can wind it up for you and get it a little bit faster, maybe. You know,
if you could get on to the telephone broadband authorities, if you just drop my name in there, you'll be upgraded immediately. You won't have to do anything else.
Well, the last time I done that, I disconnected my call.
Thank you very much, Wayne. It's wonderful to hear you. Are you not driving a bus today?
Sorry?
Are you not driving a bus today? You do bus driving as well as
No, I only do bus driving twice a week now. I do karaoke hosting and DJing, as you know, 5 days a week. So, like your good self, I work 7 days a week. But no, two days a week, I drive your local buses, and that's Monday and Tuesday.
And that's enough for you, is it?
Yeah, oh gosh, yeah. I can't cope with any more than that.
Never mind. Those lovely children will be there soon, coming on the bus for nothing. It's outrageous, dear. They don't have to pay, do they?
Thank you for making my day so nice.
I can tell that. A lot of people, after they've called into the show, their life improves dramatically. It really does. The rest of the day will be wonderful for you, Waynie, if you can just stay off those Cadbury's cream eggs.
Don't.
Of course. So yesterday, as I said, I was in Waitrose the other day, right? And I thought, and I went walking down, and I saw a box of 5 Cadbury's cream eggs. I think about £2. About £2. I thought, oh, I'll have one of those. Do you know what? In 2 days, all gone. 5 cream eggs. There's a lot to be said for going in a newsagent and just buying one. If you buy
Can I ask, Chris, how do you eat yours?
Oh, I take all the wrapper off, all of it, and then I bite off the top, and then I bite a bit more, and then I bite a bit more. I don't lick that white and yellow fondant. I like that word. Don't you like that word? Fondant. I like that word, fondant. I don't lick the fondant out of the middle. I like to bite it. How do you eat yours, Waynie?
I don't like them, so I don't eat them.
Oh, really? How can you not like Cadbury's cream eggs, dear?
No, I just don't. They're not for me.
Mind you, they've got smaller.
Cadbury's do a chocolate one now, which they started doing a couple of years ago. And I've tried those, and I have to say I like those, but I won't be buying them because they're not good for my waistline.
Oh. Well, one or two now and again don't hurt. But you see, it's the trouble I always have. If I buy 5, they will all go. Had I gone to the newsagent and bought one, since I've been to Waitrose, to this point now, I would have only had the one. But no, I've had 5 because there were 5 in a box and they were in my house. I can't buy these things in bulk anymore. It's ridiculous, isn't it? No willpower at all, Waynie.
That's why you need someone in your life, Chris, to share them with. And like your good self, I've got no one in my life to share with. So being single, you know, we have to eat them all, don't we?
All by myself, I want to be all by myself. What is your most, as a karaoke host, Waynie, what is your most hated karaoke song?
Robbie Williams, Angels.
Oh, really?
Okay. Yeah. I've only ever heard one person sing it extremely well. The rest
and that
are
wasn't, and that
normally...
wasn't Robbie Williams, was it? Oh, don't he probably watches his show? A lot of celebrities are watching his program now.
What is your one then?
Pardon? Oh no, I've got several. And I will always love you. That one.
Yeah,
I think that's possibly the biggest one that I hate. That one. Yeah, I will always love you, because most people can't sing it. Hero, Mariah Carey, and it'll usually be some old bag comes up and sings this who's just been dumped. You're my hero. My way. Oh, can I sing My Way at the end? No, you can't. Oh, why is that then? Because it's such a down record. It's down. And now, and they can't sing it. That's 3. There's 2 others. Oh, I Will Always Love You, Hero, that one. Oh, The Power of Love, that's one. 'Cause I'm your lady. And there's one more I can't think of at the moment that I'll think of as soon as someone puts it in again. You can't say no.
Can I ask, Chris, what do you think of when people put in a song that's 8 or 9 minutes long, like Son of a Preacher Man, American Pie, or Paradise by Dashboard Lights?
Yeah, but they don't just put it an 8 or 9 minute song. They put it in near the end. And when you're struggling to fit in as many people as you can, because time is time, you know, 2 o'clock means you finish at 2 o'clock.
Yes.
The amount of people that come here, certainly on a Monday night. Monday night has become so busy. Right, Monday night it's 8 till 11:30. By 9:30, I can be full up with songs.
Yes.
By 9:30, no more songs. Oh, can you squeeze me? How do you squeeze someone in? You can't. Yeah. And the only way you can squeeze someone in is to take out one of the songs that is already waiting. And I tell them time and time again, that's unfair.
Yeah.
But they put in these 8 or 9 minute songs. They might give you 2 or 3 songs. And that one they put last. And then while they're singing it, do you know what I do? Well, I shouldn't really say this. I cannot reveal this to you, lovey. Sometimes I speed up the tempo. But I do it slowly and they don't notice. But actually, that is a complete waste of time because you'll only save about 5 seconds, 5 to 10 seconds. And even if you do that 10 times, it's just a waste of time speeding up the tempo. It doesn't make any difference at all. It's a little bit like, well, you know, when you're driving along on your way home, I want to get home, you put your foot down, right? And you only save about 2 minutes. 2 minutes. Me and my mate did it once, coming home on the M3. I did 55 miles an hour. He did 70 miles an hour. The difference from London to here was about 7 minutes. That's all. Waste of time putting your foot down, costs you more money.
So can you put your foot down in that battery-powered car you got?
I beg your pardon, my hybrid RAV4, you haven't even seen it yet, have you? You'd be very impressed. It's very big, dear. Very, very big. And I'm very good at parking. I can get in. The other day, I was parking outside Central Station, and I managed to get in this gap, and I'm not lying to you, there was about 1.5 inches, if that, either side of my car.
Yeah, but you gridlocked the whole of the Euston Road while you were doing it, Chris.
How'd you work that out?
It took you an hour to get in the space.
No. Straight in. None of this forward, back. I've seen you driving your bus. Christ, going round the corner, banging up on the curb round that corner. Dear
You want to come on the bus. Hold for dear life, dear. Hold for dear life.
Are you still running that competition at the bus garage?
What's that?
The one where an elderly lady is getting off the bus and you watch her, and then just as she's about to get, just as her last leg, you push the closed door and you catch her bag or coat. And then I heard that there's a competition to see how drivers can do that. And there's a prize for the one who manages to drag the elderly lady along the road the furthest. Are you still playing that game?
No, we've started doing passenger ping pong. So what we do is we get them on the bus and we see how far we can send them down the back before they come back again.
Can you move down the bus, please? Have you got a screen? Have you got a screen between you and the passengers?
No, I wish I have, because the amount of people getting on the coughing.
Oh, aren't they disgusting? Bad breath. Bad breath. I don't like bad breath, Waynie. I always keep chewing gums next to me now in the DJ box.
Yeah.
Well, thank you for calling in, sir.
Look after yourself. Thank you.
I'll make a little note on your name to say that you've called in once. Now, once.
Okay, dear.
Cheerio, Waynie.
Bye now. Bye.
There we are, Waynie, mobile home liver, who lives actually not too far away from here at all. Don't forget, the phone lines are open this afternoon, or this morning, 020-8144-3477. I'll stay with you for about 15 minutes. I need to go and have, I forgot my pills this morning. I need to go and have those soon as well. Let's just add that there. There we are, 020-8144-3477. Is the phone number. John C says, if people Skype in, can you not show the video feed? No, I haven't found a way to do that yet, John. It's possible, I suppose, but I actually haven't looked for that yet. I'll look into that, okay, to see how we get on with that. No more messages there. Okay, now what else were we talking about? Oh, yes, so coming home from the quiz last night after Ray Reynolds' team won. Congratulations to Ray Reynolds. What am I doing here? Just a minute. I'm doing something wrong here. That's better. I unfortunately once again stopped at Five Guys, which is like the restaurant in King's Cross. burgers and chips, a bit overpriced. But the good news is that it's not all bad news. I didn't have the milkshake. So I had the spicy chips. I had the veggie, mushroomy onion burger, which is very, very nice with a bit of cheese on top. It's all freshly cooked. So you make your order and they give you a little ticket. And I had number 98 yesterday, number 98. And then just wait till they call your number out. And they're all very nice in there. I've got to say, they're all youngsters working behind there. But they all seem quite happy in their job. And I wondered if they were doing anything different to their staff that they do in McDonald's, for example. You know, because generally people in McDonald's, they don't seem to be very happy in their job, do they? In Five Guys, they are quite happy. Maybe, I mean, I suppose, I don't know what sort of money they're on. Are they on the same minimum wage as they play in these places or whatever? Or maybe they get a bit more or a bit more food, you know? So I had the mushroomy onion burger type thing, spicy chips and a Coke. I had two Cokes because that's bottomless. And that comes to about 11 quid, which I didn't think that was too bad, 11 quid. When you have a milkshake as well, because the milkshake is like £5 in there, which is a bit pricey for a milkshake, isn't it? And then I came home, came back here. I did a load of paperwork last night, actually, while I was here. I sent my meter readings off to G Energy. I send a meter reading off every week to G Energy. Came up here, done a bit of accounts because I've been self-employed. I have accounts. I was up to mid-December, so I did mid-December right up to today. You need to keep, if you're self-employed, you need to keep on top of your accounts because they can get out of control. I mean, they really can. You know, if you let them go, you've had it. You really have. And I think once I left it 6 months and then, oh, Christ, you know, picking it all up there. So I did my accounts last night, paid a couple of bills. Then I mucked around on the broadcast computer, setting up some more photographs of people that call in. So I've got, certain people that call in regularly, I'm ready for them. Now, if you were watching Waynie there and his picture came up on the side, you saw me doing that manually. But once it's done, it's there already. Look, I can bring that up now. I can bring Waynie's, with a click of a mouse, that comes straight up now, you see, that's done. And once it's saved into the system, that's it, yeah. Oh, that's the other camera there, isn't it? There we are. So once it's done, it's done. There we are. So that's what I did last night. Adam, young Adam. Now, I want to make you feel good this morning, Adam. I noticed on your little Facebook page last night, you'd put a little thing telling us that rather than losing weight, because you've done very well, you lost a lot of weight. I think it's 1 stone and 6 pounds, something like that you've lost. Last week, unfortunately, Adam put on 0.5 pound. But, Adam, it's only once. If you think carefully, Adam, and I might be able to help you with this, lovey, if you think carefully, I think you might know where that 0.5 pound came from, don't you, lovey? Huh? I think you might know where that 0.5 pound came from. And in which case, in the next week, you can do something about it. I don't think there's anything wrong with people that try and lose weight or give up smoking and they're doing so well for weeks and weeks and then suddenly they fall off and they have perhaps one cigarette or maybe a steak dinner with chips. Something like that. I don't think there's anything wrong with falling off that as long as you think, okay, I made a mistake, let's get back on it again and that's fine. It all goes wrong when that steak and chips becomes two lots of steak and chips the next day, followed by 10 cream eggs and several crowds of bags of Walkers, teas and onion crisps. Thank you very much. Yeah, so don't worry too much about that, Adam. No one's disappointed with you. And I know a lot of encouragement has to be given to people losing weight and things like that, OK? So I'm giving it to you. Get back on it, my friend, all right? And don't worry about it. 020-8144-3477. 020-8144-347 is my phone-in number this morning. Adam says, yes, I do, and it was nasty. Yeah, was it really? Well, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. Move on, Adam, move on. Good morning to Stephen, who's with us this morning. Morning, Stephen. I think you're in Australia. It must be nighttime in Australia there now, is it? Is it nighttime in Australia? I think it is there. So that was it. On the way to work last night, I came across it once again. Two, not one, but two people watching the television in their car. And the thing is about this, quite apart from it being absolutely deadly dangerous, I mean, how stupid can you be to sit there watching the television? They don't even hide it. It's not like it's on their lap and they're like that. No, they've got it attached, you know, like a sat nav, to their windscreens on the side of the car. On my life, it's attached to that, and I'm watching the pictures moving around on there. They're watching the telly. Both sports fans. I think it was football. They were both watching football on their televisions. So I've got one of their registration numbers, and I shall be reporting him. Apparently, there's somewhere on the internet that you can send in and report people for doing bad things in cars. It is ridiculous, isn't it? I mean, you know. And we've all done it. We've all done it where you go down or just change the radio channel or change the disc on the thing and you look down for a second and then you look up again and you suddenly realise how far or the bloke in front has suddenly put their brake lights on. And oh, you know. And you only look down for a second. How long do they sit there? You know what blokes are like watching the football, don't you? Oh, screaming and shouting at the television, aren't they? Like the referee can actually hear them. I don't think so. I don't think so. Yeah, oh, ref, come on, let that one in. Well, they must be exactly the same watching the telly in the car, mustn't they? Eh? Oh, it's just ridiculous. It really is. So that's it. Oh, Keith. I don't think Keith is with us this morning, is there? You may remember Keith George was having trouble using the Skype yesterday because he was using the Chris Reardon Skype, which no longer exists now. If you ever want to Skype in, the Skype username is all one word, United Kingdom Talk. Okay, United Kingdom Talk is the Skype in name if you don't want to use the phone. Or if you want to use the phone, 020-8144-3477. Some messages from yesterday's show that I wanted to read out to you. Hello to Joanna. Who says, you'll have even more homeless problems since your government are receiving refugees from the USA. Are there refugees in the USA then? What, people that want to leave the USA? Why would you ever want to leave the USA? I think that's a wonderful place to live, especially Florida. It's like you can go to Disney every day and play with Mickey Mouse or Minnie Mouse, depending on your preference. Yes. Good morning to John C. We were talking about housing yesterday. And John says, regarding housing, I was paying £295 a week in Camden for a bedsit room with shared bathroom and kitchen. However, now moved to South London to Lower Greenwich, otherwise known as Deptford. Oh, God, what a dump that is. I've driven through Deptford. You don't want to get out of your car there. Christ, that is a dodgy area. Was it Donald Trump who said there are no-go areas in London? Yes, and Deptford is one of them. Deptford is one of them. That nice mayor we've got, Sadiq Khan, didn't like that comment, didn't he? Did he? That there are no-go areas in London. There are. There are, Sadiq. Are you stupid? You must know that. There are no-go areas in London. Deptford is one of them. Because you've got people like John Child living there, waiting to mug you as you walk round the corner. John says he now lives it's not Lower Greenwich, it's Deptford, mate, Deptford. He now lives in Deptford and he's paying £210 a week for a two-bedroom flat. That doesn't sound bad. Is that on your own, John, or do you rent a room out or what? £210, I suppose you could rent a room out, what, £100 a week? You'd only be paying £100 each, and that sounds quite reasonable, doesn't it? Tony Power says he popped into the Two Brewers last night and noticed there's a special delivery from me. A packet of French fancy cakes. Oh, they're nice. Oh, I might have a couple of those tonight. They must be from Ray. Ray often brings me in. Ray B. It's Ray Bree. He often brings me in French fancy cakes. I don't know why he brings me in French fancy cakes and nothing else, but I do like those. They are quite nice. Yes, indeed. Stephen's with us this morning. He's in Brisbane, Australia. Now, I've been to Brisbane. I think I was only there for 24 hours. I went to see a friend of mine who I used to work with in Belushes. And, it's so hot there. And in Brisbane, they've got outside the town hall. Now, this is a really hot place, really hot, where the sun shines permanently. It seems to shine permanently. And it's very, very sticky. And what have they got on the floor outside the town hall there? Marble. I mean, you couldn't think of anything worse to put outside a building where it's always sunny, Kenya. They've got marble on the floor. I remember when I was there, people were walking across this floor and their feet were literally sticking to this stone floor. They've also got this great big artificial pool, you know, not natural, like a lake, artificial lake that you can go swimming in. And that was actually quite pleasant. But in that sort of heat, it was like getting into a warm bath. You know, obviously no one wants to get into water when it's cold. My God, up at the swimming pool, don't they moan when that water's not hot? Oh, dear. My mate's one of those. He moans about the slightest thing. It doesn't matter. You know, if it feels a little bit chilly to me, I don't say anything. It's got to be really cold for me to make a complaint. But people moan. Oh, isn't it cold today? Have you not got the water heating on? Oh, they do moan over there, Stephen. They really do. We'll do one more story then, boys and girls, and then we'll do today's birthdays, OK? Check this out. Shoppers, like me and you, have picked Waitrose and Lidl over the big four chains. High-end and budget supermarkets come out in top of a survey of 7,000 customers in-store and online experience. Yes, indeed. Sainsbury's, Asda, Tesco's and Morrison's have been put in their place, but upmarket Waitrose and cut price Aldi and Lidl in a major survey. The consumer group, which asked more than 7,000 people about their experience in, this was in today's Daily Mail, of shopping supermarkets during the past 6 months, both in-store and online. It said Waitrose helpful staff, and this is absolutely true. You go in a Waitrose, you will not experience customer services like that in any other supermarket. You really won't. It says Waitrose helpful staff won over shoppers for their in-store survey, with customers saying its spacious layouts made groceries easy to find. And let me tell you, if you go in a Waitrose, it's very, very relaxing. Me and Ronnie, we used to go in there 3 or 4 times a week just for the tea. We'd go in there, buy a couple of items, and then go in the restaurant and have a cup of tea and maybe a biscuit or a bag of crisp sandwich. Oh, do you like my lamp? Look at this lamp. It's like this. I wanted to show you this. I've had it a while. I haven't shown this. Look at that. Isn't that nice? Lamp. Look at that. It's camp, isn't it? It's like a Dalek, isn't it? Exterminate. Marks and Spencer's regular... Oh, I'm going to sneeze. I think. No, maybe not. No sneezing. No. Marks and Spencer's regular dining offers, which often include a meal for two and a bottle of wine for £10, were also found to be a hit with shoppers, helping to take it in second place. And again, Marks and Spencer's. The food in there is really nice. They do, and I've mentioned this before, a wonderful mushroom and onion pie. And it's got potato on the top, about £2.40, I think it is. Oh, it's delicious. Add that with a few vegetables, very nice. Aldi and Lidl were placed joint third, which says they were evenly matched, with both scoring particularly well on value for money. If you want cheap, Aldi and Lidl. You won't really get the customer service in Aldi, they're just too busy. They'll talk to you, hello, very efficient. There's a German bloke who works in the Aldi near me, and he's really, really efficient. Very efficient. You know, typically German. Good morning, sir, how are you today? Yes, thank you. Anything else, sir? Thank you. That's £1.30, please. Thank you very much, sir. See you again soon. Bye-bye. Good morning, madam. He's a bit like that. Very, very efficient and a nice man. I've seen him a couple of times over the sports centre. Morrison's climbed from 8th place last year to number 5 this year. Asda is at the bottom of the table in 9th place. No, I quite like Asda. They're big and everything's in there, isn't there? You don't need to go anywhere else other than Asda. It's all there. I quite like Asda, I do. Asda was seen by consumers as being generally good value, but its food quality was rated as average. Meanwhile, Iceland's online service was ranked the best for internet grocery shopping. Now, I didn't know Iceland deliver. I don't do any of that internet ordering from supermarket. Oh, I must go and have my pills in a minute. I didn't know they did. They did internet ordering. I don't do that at all. I've never done that. That internet shopping order. You know, isn't it £5 or £6 each time? That's £5 or £6 you could be spending out on extra Mars bars or ice cream. You get 2 tubs of carton or ice cream for that. Very tasty. So there we are. In-store scores were based on factors such as their appearance, how easy it was to find products, and the overall quality of fresh products. So that's interesting, that is. So Waitrose and Lidl and Aldi to the top of the queue. Thank you very much. Right. Let's do today's birthdays in a second. One moment. Stephen said it was 41 degrees a few days ago in Brisbane. Oh, it's too hot for me. Oh, that would do me in. That really is too hot. I think in Sydney a few years ago, I'll never forget that. I was out with my cousin Helen. We were doing a bit of shopping and we were walking around. I was in the sun. You couldn't get out of the sun. It was shining straight on us. And in the end, I had to go into a shopping centre. I'd just become overcome with the heat and that constant force of sunlight on you. So I know 41 degrees would do me in. Oh, dear, dear me. Right. John says, John's got the two-bedroom flat on his own, has he? Okay, so you don't share there. Fair enough. Right, let's do today's birthdays, boys and girls, and then we'll be off for today. Good morning and happy birthday today to the lovely, delicious Angela Washington, who I met in... Where did I meet you, Angela, first? Was it the O2 or was it Florida? No, it was Florida. I'm sure it was Florida, and we did a little interview with you at a Barry Manilow concert, didn't we? Happy birthday today to the lovely Angela Washington. All right, Angela, I hope to meet up again with you soon, my darling, all right? To Robbie Warren. Happy birthday, Robbie. I think you're 60 today, aren't you? Happy birthday to Robbie, all right? Happy birthday to Markey Rafferty. Looking good with your dog there, darling. 29 years old today. So young, Mark. So young. Luke Taylor. Little Luke Taylor, how are you? It's been a while since we chatted on the phone. Happy birthday to Luke Taylor, who'd be jetting off somewhere and was always on a plane going somewhere. Craig Mark Davis, it's your birthday today. Happy birthday to Craig Mark Davis. Glen Playstar. Hope you're doing well, Glen. Jacinta Corrigan is 31 years old. Lovely name, Jacinta. Hope I've said that. Jacinta Corrigan. Tommy Kivlihan. Kivlahan? Is that about right? 25 years old today. So young, Tommy. So young. Do you know I'm over twice your age, Tommy? But isn't it funny how I still look so young, Tommy? No work done to my face. No way. Leigh Last of internet radio fame is 23 years old today. And Vivek Joseph is 24 years old today. So let's do the song. Happy birthday, happy birthday, happy birthday to you. All right. Enjoy your birthdays, you lot over there. Let's just do any more messages there and we'll disappear. Just refresh my page and we're bang up to date. That's it today. Thank you very much for watching and listening to the show, boys and girls. It's a Thursday night, so I'll be doing a bit of DJing tonight at the Two Brewers in Clapham. We've got Cabaret on stage at midnight with the lovely Tanya Hyde. So that's Tanya Hyde and myself tonight at the Two Brewers in Clapham on this Thursday night, the 16th of February 2017, as I was corrected by someone earlier. We do like a little bit of correction. Have a lovely Thursday, and I'll see you again very soon. Bye-bye now.